So we're going to wire some new construction today. Here in the country I was born in, we use a 12-2 on 20 amps and 14-2 on 15 amps. Black is live, white is neutral, bare or the green is the ground. And red and blue are also live colors. So we're going to get to work now. All right, we're going to put 20 amp GFI in and a 20 amp outlet protected by the GFI. Okay, we're going to hook our GFI receptacle up in here. If you look at the back, you'll see where it says line and load, and we have our ground wire terminal here. So we'll get our ground wires together here. I twist my ground wires together here. Clip them so they're even here. These are the barrel crimp sleeves, and we'll crimp these. That will save the That way you'll save room because we won't have to have a wire nut. And just squeeze it nice and tight. We have our ground wires together here. And I'll just push these back into the back of the box. And then we'll have our black and white load in our black and white line here. You can see. Okay, I'm going to hold this up to our device just for measurement. Okay, that's, I'm going to just make it slightly longer here. This is the black and white line. Here in the country I was born in, white is neutral, black is live. And we use a 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps. So I'll put the ground under the green one there. Make sure the copper goes up to the back of the pressure plate there. Okay, so this is line, so we'll put the white line in on this side here. And this is the black line, so we'll put it over on this side. Okay, we'll put our black load up here. the white load on the silver side. In the kitchen by this, within 6 feet of the sink, a JFI is required, and the bathroom outlets, a JFI is required. Okay, this ground wire is down away from everything. I'm not going to screw it in all the way because they're going to be putting sheetrock up and they'll have to unscrew it to hang the sheetrock. Okay, so we'll hook our outlet up. I just ripped the end of there. I'm going to take this spring off. Okay, I'm going to strip with the number 12 hole here. Okay, I'm gonna close the screws we're not gonna be using. Okay, I'll just hold these up here, make sure they're long enough to get under the pressure plate. And they're good. So I'll put the black on the brass side here. Okay, I'm going to clip a slight bit off that there. That's going to be good there. Make sure it's tight. Close one we're not going to use. Close the screw the direction that the loop turns. The ground screws don't like the Phillips screwdriver, so I'm going to tighten it with the flathead. Make sure it's tight. Okay, so I'll fold these into the box. Black and white go up and down like an accordion here. And then keep the ground wire down to the bottom. So now the this outlet is protected by the GFI. And I'm not going to screw this down till because they're going to put sheetrock up. Okay, so this is by the kitchen sink within 6 feet, so we have to put a GFI here. Okay, so the one that's the power is going to be the one on the left. And this is the out one. They're going to move this box a little bit and put a piece of wood in to nail it to, a 2x4. So I just tacked it here temporarily. And all the debris off. Okay, I'll take my pliers here, I'll pull back and bring these wires up a little bit so that the jacket's not in the box too far. There it is. That's back up where I want it. Okay, I'm gonna be going to two devices here, so I'm gonna cut these. Here in the country I was born in, ground wire is bare or green. You never use it for a neutral. If we can't put four wires in that crimp sleeve, we will use a red wire nut. Yep. Yes. Okay, it's fitting right on there nice and snug. Okay. Well, it'd be nice if I had my crimpers. This is them. Okay, so I'm going to just tap it down, make sure it's down all the way. And you squeeze it real tight. So I got a nice big crimp there. See the line all the way up through? Okay, so we will push this back here out of the way. This is, the black and white line got tangled up in here, so I'll bring it over here, there. So we have a ground each device. We're going to hook the GFI up. Okay, if you see the back here, you'll see where it says line for the power in and load for the power out. And we'll hook this up. Okay, I'm gonna just check my strip lengths, make sure they're long enough. Yep. Okay, they're all long enough, so we'll start with our ground wire. Okay, look. This is line, so we'll put the black line over here and the white line in here. The white load over here. Black line up here. Okay. Well, now we're going to go to another outlet. So we're going to leave the white load out. Oh, wait a minute. I had this mixed up here. This is the white load, and the black line goes down here. There we go. Okay, now we're going to get our black and white to go over to the second outlet here. Okay, I'm going to just check my strip length. that's gonna be good. Now I'll just check the white one here. Yep, okay. And we'll pigtail these together to go to the outlet. Okay, here in the country I was born in, we use wire nuts to pigtail our wires together. Clip them so they're all even. This will go to the outlet. Okay, here in the country I was born in, your black wire is live and the white is neutral. I'll close the screws I'm not using. You gotta make sure it's long enough to get on the pressure plate, and it is. I'm gonna put the ground wire around the green screw here. Always put your wire around the screw the way that the screw turns. Okay, there's our white wire. We'll get our black over here. So I'll bring the camera down close so you can see it. Okay, this is gonna. I'll leave the loop of slack here in case we have to move it. Okay, now we'll hook our outlets up. Yeah, I have one up here for this. Thank you. close the screws I'm not going to be using. Okay, so I'll put a black and white on this one. Go along. On the brass screw, the white goes on the silver. Tight, close the one we're not using. Tight, close the one we're not using, and we'll hook our ground wire up. Okay, we'll close the one we're not using. The ground on the green screw, white goes on the silver colored screw. And the black goes on the brass colored screw. Close. Now we're going to use this one. We're not using that one. Okay, it's a little long. Hook a little more up. There we go. Notice the neutral slot is wider and the live slot is narrower. I'll bring the camera up close so you can see it. Okay, we got our 12-2 over to the box. There we go. come that thing's not opening up? There it goes. Okay, we'll get it centered here in the connector. So I'm gonna see how much I'm gonna need. I can cut some of this off here. Just rip the end here a little bit. Okay, so first we'll get our ground wire over to the neutral bar, and we'll put it in with this number 12 right here. So I'll push it to the back of the box. I'll come over. Well, they crossed over each other.
Hello, Dave.
Hi.
Hello.
There it is. Now they're on top.
Just me. Wow.
You know what?
What's that? Okay, now we'll bring our white wire.
Very good.
Push it to the back. And I will come to this one right here. Hi, Dick. How are you?
Good. All right, just checking. Wow.
And where's the empty one? It's right there. So I'm going to bend it right here. Okay, so here in the country I'm born in, we use 20 amps on 12 gauge wire, 14 gauge wire on 15 amps. So we're using 12 gauge on 20 amps. So I'll push this to the back. So I'm going to come down and I'm going to keep it in line here, make my bend here, and I'm going to cut right here. So that is how to wire a dedicated GFI circuit here in the country I was born in. Peace. Thanks for watching.